Dear Gradettes, normally I would be standing today in a room together with you, with more than a thousand of you in fact, and together with your families and friends. We would all be wearing robes and we would have just paraded around Rotterdam. And probably we would have had to hand out more than 1,000 umbrellas too, because the weather oftentimes isn't as nice as it is today. Of course, over the last 2 months, a lot of things have changed. What has happened has affected you and your studies. It's also affected your families and friends. And of course, the last few months here at RSM have been very different from how they were supposed to be. But one thing has not changed, and that is the value of your degree that you are graduating with today. You've worked incredibly hard during these circumstances, and it is wonderful to see what you have achieved during these last few months as you have faced those challenges. I know it's not been easy, but I also know that your families and your friends are incredibly proud of you. I hope that we will have the opportunity to celebrate at some point in person. I would really love that. But for now, let's think about what you have achieved and also what you're going to do next. All of you are going into the world now. You are going to take up new opportunities. You're going to have to make choices as well. The choices you make and the opportunities you seek are what makes you and are all of us a force of positive change in this world. And I'm really so grateful for your willingness to be part of this mission. So, congratulations. You've done really well. We are proud of you. I wish you all the best, and I hope to see you very, very soon.
Hello, my name is Bram van den Berg. I am the Academic Director of the MSc in Marketing Management. Dear students, on behalf of the entire Department of Marketing Management, congratulations. I'm very proud of all of you, especially considering how exceptional the past year has been. It was difficult. Some of you had to leave Rotterdam instantly to take care of relatives. Some of you had side jobs and worked for businesses that went bankrupt. Some of you had difficulties coping with the social isolation. And taking online classes is not obvious either. Without access to classrooms, you had to deal with noisy flatmates and lousy Wi-Fi connections. You had to cope with professors who had to improvise when moving offline classes to an online environment. And you had to find alternative ways to meet up with students, to work on group assignments, and you had to revise how to collect data for your thesis. But you made it. Despite the challenges, despite the obstacles and the hurdles that were bigger than ever before. And let me say, in all honesty, that I am impressed by how you responded to all these challenges. In the past year, you had to be flexible and pragmatic. You had to be agile. You had to improvise. But this is ultimately what life is about, because nobody knows what's going to happen next. This pandemic has challenged all of us, but it also provided us with an opportunity to develop ourselves and further grow our skills and our talents. Your diploma is a testimony of your ability to pick up knowledge. You have demonstrated that you are capable of picking up that knowledge, even in difficult times. And even though it's virtual, today we celebrate that you're officially a grown-up. It's difficult to predict what lies ahead of us, but I'm confident that all of you will rise to the occasion. Your classmates, your friends, your cohort will not be defined by what the pandemic has taken from you, but you will be defined by how you responded to it. But you cannot rest on your laurels. This year, it became clear that we can never assume that we have figured it all out. My unsolicited advice for the future is therefore to keep on learning. A smart person once said that everyone you will ever meet knows something that you probably don't. The plumber who repairs your leaky bathtub or the bus driver on your way to work, they know stuff that you probably don't. Respect their knowledge and try to learn from them. Your next door colleague, your mom, your little niece, your boss, and the person that is maybe watching this video with you, they all know something that you probably don't. Respect their knowledge and learn from them. Your formal schooling years are over now, but the informal learning will continue. And if there is something that the past year has taught us, is that we can learn to overcome even the biggest of challenges. From now on, you are in the driver's seat. More than ever, it's now your turn to challenge the status quo. It's now your turn to shape the world. And I'm curious to see what you will make of it. I'm sure that you will not just put the pieces back together, but that you will create a better, a kinder, and a nicer future for all of us. I am proud of you. I wish you the best of luck. Congratulations again.
Over 50 years ago, a few bright minds planted the seeds to become a force for positive change in the world, developing thought leaders in business, research, and education.
It was a unique opportunity to join the first academic business school in the Netherlands. It was a life-changing experience and made my career. I'm grateful that I learned all the different aspects of business with my RSM degree.
In the 1980s, we launched a full set of management programs at RSM. And that way, we laid the foundations for a top business school in Europe.
I'm very proud that since the 90s, RSM has become an international business school known for its excellence in research.
Leadership of today is not driven by self-interest, but by a vision that gives us direction to the sustainable change we so badly need.
Shared values and a sense of community, it is impossible to overcome the current global challenges.
We empower women to drive their careers and be agents of change in creating a more gender equal work environment.
It's an honor to lead such an impactful business school. Going forward, it is going to be crucial to find the right balance between continuity and change in order to create new opportunities for the next 50 years.
I will be the agent of positive change.
I am ready for the future.
Rotterdam School of Management. Erasmus University. 50 years of impact.
Good afternoon, everyone. Professors, class of 2020, families and friends. Let me start with a big thank you to the Academic Director, Professor Vandenberg. It's been an honor for me to serve as student representative this year, as well as to give this brief speech. First of all, congratulations to all of us for being here and being the only cohort to ever graduate in the middle of a pandemic. Milestones of a certain magnitude are always worth celebrating, regardless the circumstances. I know most of us had envisioned a different ending to this chapter, and none of us would have imagined we would be doing our thesis dissertation from our living room, with parents cheering from the couch and our dogs sitting next to us. But let's not forget that we've just made it to the end of our academic journey, and that in and of itself is worth celebrating. We did this. It's true that a graduation ceremony feels a lot different when we can see and stay close to each other in person, hug our family members, and take those pictures that will help us remember this moment forever. But I'd like to think that graduating doesn't only mean throwing your cap in the air. As a student called Sam Demon once said, graduating is represented by the readiness to take on the next challenge, to move forward in life. So let's celebrate something that coronavirus will never take away from us. Let's celebrate the start of a new job or 5 more years of education. Let's celebrate the launch of your own venture, writing a book or starting a movement. Let's celebrate the beginning of a new chapter in our lives. I know it's easy to get caught up in the negatives sometimes, as we all feel like COVID took away half of our masters. Suddenly, no more classes, no more studying together in the library, no more committee work, no more drinks or celebration. And now, no more graduation ceremony. We are now entering the job market at one of the most critical times in history, with a health crisis and global economies devastated. But I'd like to invite you all to focus on the positives. And if it's true that what doesn't kill you makes you stronger, let's try to turn this period into something that one day we'll look back at and remember as a moment of growth and opportunity. I hope that one day we'll be grateful for the lessons on resilience and flexibility that this situation is teaching us. We are now dealing with the greatest setback that a generation ever had to face, and we've done an amazing job at adapting to an incredibly uncertain environment, staying connected, supportive towards each other, and collaborative within our communities. They say life is 10% what happens to you and 90% how you react to it. And I can't find a better example than the current global situation to show us what that means. We can't control the obstacles around us, but what we can control is how we respond to them. And I hope we'll all be able to take away something from this experience, something that will be valuable for our careers and future lives. Learning to be comfortable with being uncomfortable, tolerating uncertainty, and dealing with setbacks and failures. And remember, tough times don't last, tough people do. Of course, now we're all feeling as if we've come to an end, and the day we've been dreaming of has finally come. Everything seems to be over. But let's try to see this day as a beginning more than an end. Today marks the beginning of our working life and our impact into the world. And together with the endless opportunities that now open up in front of us, responsibilities will also come. I am sure this cohort is full of future leaders, managers, innovators, and groundbreakers. Our generation and the ones to come have multitudes of challenges lying ahead, so choose your battles wisely. Keep daring and striving for excellence, but always bring our RSM motto with you as you venture out into the world, and be a force for positive change, always aiming to make this world a more just and equitable place. So thank you, RSM, for empowering us students to be the change we want to see in the world, for teaching us to dream big, smart, start small, and scale fast. And thank you also because COVID separated us, but RSM made sure we stayed connected and sticked together till the end. Thank you, fellow graduates, for inspiring each other every day and for making this journey absolutely fun and unforgettable. And last but not least, thank you to all our parents, professors, coaches, friends and families for supporting us and cheering us up through highs and lows. Thank you for making everything possible. So congratulations, class of 2020. All the very best and good luck on your new adventures. Thank you.
We wanted to create a place where you can go back in time and explore all the stories of the 50-year RSM history. A complete timeline that not only tells those stories, but also instills a sense of pride about the history and ignites inspiration for the future. After months of work by many, hunting and digging through the archive, puzzling all the pieces together, it's with great honor that I get to unveil and present to you the official 50-year historical timeline of Rotterdam School of Management, Erasmus University. The first part of our timeline is a story of many firsts. The first plans, the first school building, the first classroom, and of course, the first students. The first item on our timeline, and my favorite piece, is this one-page business plan. It was made by our founding fathers, and they compared four European business schools, and they used it to design the school and the curriculum. The beginning of our timeline contains a picture of our very first school building. And on this school building, of course, there was a building sign. This is the original building sign from 1970, and luckily, it survived the past 50 years. Another great discovery from the RSM archives are these three pictures. They were scattered amongst hundreds of pictures, and after studying them for a while, we figured out that they fit together, creating a beautiful panorama of one of the first classrooms. If you look closely, you see a blackboard with a process flow. Of course, you see 1970s students with long hair and their appropriate clothes. And at the very back of the classroom, in the window, you see two beer bottles. Let's just say things were a bit different in the 70s. This first part of our timeline is quite dynamic. Our newly formed school grows. We welcome more students. And after a while, it's the start of the MBA program, the PhD program. In 1977, SVIEP is founded, which is currently called STAR. And we moved the school from Rotterdam to Delft. The second part of our timeline is even more dynamic. After over 10 years, our school moves back from Delft to Rotterdam, to the FG building in 1984. Here it becomes a proper academic faculty, part of the state-recognized Erasmus University. In this phase, it's all about further internationalization, development, expansion, and academic recognition. In 1989, RSM is admitted into the prestigious Community of European Management Schools, CEMS, and the PIM network, Program in International Management. The exchange program of RSM starts to take shape in a tremendous way. Here, on the timeline, we see a graduation ceremony taking place in the early years. In the mid-1980s, the new FG building allowed for a lot of space for a new computer lab. The importance of automation in the workplace was on the rise, and the shape and size of computers changed over the years. RSM has always invested heavily in those facilities because of their importance for education. Nowadays, everybody just brings their own device. The early 90s marked the birth of the internet. And our timeline describes how new ways of doing research and delivering education were developed. For instance, in the late 90s, as part of the Dr. Anders 2000 project, RSM started experimenting with delivering video lectures on CD-ROMs.
Welkom bij dit college over leiderschap.
Students were learned how to code in Delphi and other programming languages. And from 2000 onward, the faculty implemented digital case methods. For instance, this adventure game case, where learning, testing, grading and fraud detection all was done via advanced CD-ROMs and floppy disks. The last part of our timeline is all about further growth and integration. RSM becomes one brand name, unifying all research and programs under one label. We continue to climb the most important rankings. We welcome more students, we make more impressive publications, and our name continues to grow as a brand name in the market. In 2009, the I Will movement launches. Students, staff, and faculty make a public commitment to their drive and ambitions, reflecting RSM spirit. By 2020, there are no more than 15,000 statements, In 2017, RSM embarks on a new strategic mission to become a force for positive change. By embracing the UN's Sustainable Development Goals, they try to implement a new way of measuring societal impact. And this concludes my brief overview of the RSM timeline. Come over to the Mandeville building and have a look yourself, or go over to the Bale building where we have an identical timeline set up. Or you can go to rsm.nl/50 to find more online resources, videos, and all the stories of the 50-year RSM history. Come and explore our shared history now.
Adriana Georgieva.
Hi guys, so probably none of us expected to graduate like this, but I want to wish to everyone, including myself, a very bright future, and remember, the future belongs to the brave.
Agata Alinska. Agata Maciak. Aim Samantai. Aina Reljic, cum laude. Alexandra Bol. Alice Martini. Alicia Semedo. Amparito Sanders. Annabel Arndt. Andrea Lezzi.
Hey everybody, congrats.
Annick Vos. Anna Dovgal, cum laude. Anna Timmerman. Annico Buisman. Anouk Samaye Krasto. Anouk Masteling. Aurelia Vikaite, cum laude. Beatrice Cipriano Mangua Henrique. Bensu Karabai. Peach Dao. Blanca Sabo, cum laude. Bosidir Nikolov. Brigitte Pestarosti.
Congratulations to everyone who is receiving their master's degree today. I want to thank my mom, my dad, my sister, and my friends. And in particular, I want to dedicate this one to my grandfather.
Sam Gulbayir. Christine Liu. Daphne Buskoop. Daria Selevica. David Houwen. Davina Ko. Dolores Egink. Torte Bussink. Irini Karagiorga. Eleftheria Strin. Elena Corsiglia, cum laude. Elitsa Kostova. Elsa Lindemulder. Elsemieke Spargaren. Emma Hendricks. Emma van der Klundert. Emma van Veldhoven. Esmee Plukaert. Fabienne Fuik. Gemma Frommeten.
I would just like to say thank you very much to my family and my friends for all their support during my master's. I'm grateful for everything you do for me. Thank you.
George Sioraru. Giacomo Alpiani.
Graduation for me represents the end of one of the most wonderful chapters of my life. So I'm sure that when this is all over, we'll find a way to celebrate properly. Maybe at La Grande Bellezza 4.
Gijs Kouwenhoven. Gwen van Wijk. Hanna Lutsen. Hanna Paardenkoper. Hanne Hoonhout. Ina Kroos. Isa van der Werf. Isabel Verheggen. Janita van Beinum. Janna Koer. Jelena Langerbeins. Jelmer Leek. Jennifer van Dulken.
Congratulations everybody, we made it! I would like to thank my family, friends and boyfriend for their support along this journey.
Jeremy Markham. Joris Kelder. Josephine van Kaam. Josje Rovers. Julia Bartsch, cum laude. Julia da Graça Morai. Julia Murphy, cum laude.
Thank you to my friends and family, and especially my mom and dad for all their support this year, and congratulations to all my fellow 2020 graduates.
Julia Taser, cum laude.
Happy graduation! I want to thank my parents who supported me throughout the journey, the friends that I've made along the way, and wish all the best to my fellow graduates. Cheers!
Julie Verheijden. Juliette Jansen. Juliette Simon, cum laude. Jurre Kluin. Kari Koek. Karim Rubio. Kaylee Riding. Kim van der Laken, cum laude. Kim van Leeuwen. Kimberly Shaw. Lama Elboreini. Larissa Chua. Laura Koelman, cum laude.
I'm super proud that we all accomplished our master's degree even in this crazy year, so cheers to class 2020, make your way.
Lauren Hoeks, cum laude.
The old Taylor can't come to the phone right now. Why? Oh, because she's dead.
Lena Bukkers. Langley Jiang. Lisa Orto-Johan, cum laude. Lisanne Dingjan. Luca Roat.
I did my best to notice when the call.
Madhavi Richpal. Madeleine Cargito. Madou Rijmeringer. Malte Zandbergen. Marije Driessen. Mark Maas. Marleen van Tussenbroek. Marloes Gutter. Martina Makreli, cum laude. Matthias Wynorowski. Mattia Rizzi.
Yes guys, we did it. Thanks to my family and all my friends that supported me. No, seriously though, if you're interested in internship opportunities at a big tech company, just hit me up.
Max van Dam, cum laude. Mayul de Kerels. Mercedes Roggen. Mariem Benami El Ouabi.
Hi Erasmus and fellow graduates. Thank you for all the years at the Rotterdam School of Management. I'm looking forward to what is coming next and wish you all a healthy future. Thank you.
Michelle de Haas, cum laude. Miguel Guedes Neves Duarte de Oliveira. Mila van Sloten. Mira Klaasens. Myrthe Koning, cum laude. Morticia van der Klei. Nadja van Drie.
Woehoe, we did it!
Nathalie Vogel, cum laude. Nicole Hodgson. Niklas Beiderwieden. Nino van Zandwijk.
Thank you mom, dad, Donna, opa, oma and all my friends. And for class 2020, stay optimistic, creative and keep challenging yourself.
Olivier Moussel, cum laude. Parel Blonk. Pauline Groenendaal. Pim Nelemans. Pippi Melief. Quaraisha Thuis. Rachel Yuen. Raminta Bereite. René Kneisler. Ricardo Geri. Rosanne Heren, cum laude. Ryan van Velzen. Saba Perket. Sergei Zhukov. Sophie van Schagen. Stefan Peeman. Stephanie Makunza. Steven van Leur. Supreet Singh. Susanna Uter, cum laude. Susanne Bakkers. Tess de Roy. Theodoros Chronopoulos.
My friends, I want to thank everyone for the amazing memories we had the last year and the genuine relationships we formed, and wish to everyone good luck with your future endeavors. Greetings from Greece.
Teresa Rieger. Tu Nguyen. Timon Hendricks.
Afgestudeerd, dankjewel daarvoor. Ik zal mijn diploma met alle plezier in ontvangst nemen. Klein bedankje naar mijn ouders. Eigenlijk een heel groot bedankje. Mijn broer, de stichting, mijn club Adonis.
Timothy Xanthopoulos. Waiwachu. Wiebke Koekenberg. Yashita Atmaram.
Congratulations, your hard work's paid off and you are now no longer students, you are RSM alumni, and we are so incredibly proud of each and every one of you. I just wanted to let you know that you are now part of an alumni community that is global, and community and networks are ever more important. So please stay in touch with us, stay in touch with each other, and I look forward to seeing you again in the future.
Congratulations to all of you.
New doors are opening and are taking you to directions that you have never expected.
And I'm sure you'll be able to overcome
all the challenges that this year brought us.
You've made it. I am hugely proud of you, and I hope you can cherish this amazing moment.
Welcome to this wonderful alumni network.
You can set an example.
It is your time now to make positive change happen.